Here at the University of Manchester, researchers have uncovered what some are calling one of the greatest discoveries of the 21st century, an innovation so small it can barely be seen. This is graphene, a man-made reworking of an element found in every organic thing on Earth, carbon.
So graphene is the world's first two-dimensional material. Everything around us in the world is three-dimensional, which means it's got a length, a width, and a height. But graphene is two-dimensional, which means it's just got a length and a width, like it's a single sheet of atoms. So it's like a sheet of paper, but a million times thinner than that.
Why did that make it so special?
Yeah, so graphene's got this amazing list of superlative properties. It's a long list, which is the thinnest material in the world. It's the lightest, it's the strongest, it's the best conductor of electricity, it's the best conductor of heat, etc., etc.
Since graphene was first named in 1962, scientists, researchers, industrialists, and even science fiction writers have speculated on its almost limitless potential. But there was just one problem. No one could actually produce it. Then, in 2004, two university professors, Andrei Geim and Kostya Novozelov, took a radical but simple step that put Manchester on the map and earned them a Nobel Prize in physics.
The first easy way of making graphene was discovered here at the university by Andrei and Kostya, which was basically to use some sticky tape like sellotape, take it to a piece of graphite, and then you just peel off.
And this is just an ordinary piece of graphite, just a chunk of graphite?
Just a rock of graphite that you mine out of the ground, and then you peel off one layer of that graphite, which is graphene, and you put it down on various surfaces, and then you can look at it, you can play with it, you can make things with it.
So can we go see some graphene now?
Yeah, sure, let's go make some graphene.
And graphene production has gone decidedly upscale from those early days. Now it's created inside custom cleanroom on the university's campus using a silicon conduit to split graphite into single layers.
What we see here is you have flakes of graphite and graphene on top of your silicon wafer. And if you look here, you'll see some dark blue areas. So these are quite thick. They mean tens of layers of graphene. And then as you go thinner and thinner, the color gets lighter and lighter. So if you look at the lightest sheets here, they're single sheets of carbon, so that's the graphene. So what we do is we have to go hunting around to find the really, really thin stuff.
So this is graphene hunting?
This is graphene hunting, exactly.
The researchers have even created a liquid graphene they hope can be used to print electronic circuitry, potentially removing the need for copper and silicon.
Graphene can be used in a variety of different applications, everything from structural applications like aircraft or cars to consumer electronics, mobile phones, screens, for example, medical applications, drug delivery, wound healing.
But despite all that promise, there are still barriers. Graphene might be one of the world's most innovative materials, but it doesn't come cheap. One tiny fleck of graphene made from one of these bits of graphite would set you back about £1,000. But that hefty price tag isn't totally deterring researchers who say a cheaper way to use graphene is to incorporate it with other materials so it adopts some of the characteristics. That promise of power is happening right here at the University of Manchester's National Graphene Institute, a research production facility being set up between private industry and the UK and EU parliaments.
Partnership is very important because we need to understand the needs and requirements of the end users and the supply chain as well. So as part of the National Graphene Institute, we have a large area just for commercial companies. We have nearly 10,000 square feet of space for partners to work alongside the scientists, alongside the supply chain companies. What we want companies to do is to take that science and turn it into products and processes, and that will open up the commercial opportunities for applications of graphene going forward.
So, what industries does graphene have the possibility of revolutionising? Well, seawater could be easily desalinated. The weight of our satellites, planes and cars could be dramatically cut, and they'd be rust-free forever. Graphene has the potential to absorb radioactive waste, and it could be perfect for a whole new generation of smartphones. Add to that, batteries could be recharged in nanoseconds.